This is how torque flows through the Archimedes drive. We start where motion begins, at the input sun. This input drives the compressed planets through traction. Idling suns are free-floating hollow rings, allowing for uniform compression along the planets. The planets are surrounded by fixed ground annuli, pressing against the outer side of the planets. Both ground annuli are connected by a yoke. The difference in diameter between the inner and outer side of the planets generate rotational motion at the output. Let's dive into the mechanical principles that make this possible. At its core, the Archimedes drive behaves like a compound lever. Changing the compound geometry of the planet shifts the leverage. As the input sun rotates, it generates an input velocity at one side of the lever. The fixed ground annuli form the fulcrum, the structural pivot of the planet. At the other end of the lever, a velocity reduction is achieved based on its relative position to the fulcrum. By adjusting the diameters of the planets, we adjust the step size between the inner and outer sides of the planet. This step defines the reduction ratio. Increasing the step size means a lower reduction. Reducing the step size means a higher reduction. Differences in wall thickness, compression force, the number of planets, and even their shape define the final characteristics, like the slip torque of the drive. With the planetary compound traction principle at its core, the Archimedes drive becomes a fully customizable high-performance speed reducer.